Hello, I'm Dale Ireland with Syngenta Seed Care here in Valmeyer, Illinois, to talk about sudden death syndrome, or more commonly called SDS, of soybean. Sudden death syndrome is caused by a root infection by Fusarium virgiliforme and is encouraged by cool, wet conditions early. The familiar symptoms you see in the leaf canopy in mid to late August is actually caused by the disease toxins being moved from the roots into the leaf tissue, causing those familiar yellow chlorotic spots and then premature leaf drop eventually. The earlier this disease comes into your field, or the earlier you see it, the more it will impact your yield. Anytime you prematurely defoliate your soybean crop, obviously, depending on the growth stage, you will have reduced flowers or blooms, reduced numbers of pods, or reduced numbers of beans within pods, and depending on if it comes in late enough, you may only have it affect the bean size within the existing pods that are present. So it all depends on when sudden death syndrome starts to express itself by destroying leaf tissue as to the severity of the disease's effect on your final yield. You can have root infection but never see the symptoms, the familiar symptoms in the leaves, and still have yield loss. So it's really a complex disease. It's encouraged by cool, wet weather early, then very good growing conditions throughout the growing season, including repeated wet, dry, raining and drying periods, as well as low relative temperatures throughout the growing season. When you do experience multiple weeks of very hot, dry weather, this should slow down the development of sudden death syndrome. We normally see our worst sudden death syndrome when we have cool, wet conditions early, and then very moderate, cooler than normal summer conditions with plentiful rainfall. SDS was first found in Arkansas back in the early 70s, and since then has moved up the Mississippi River Delta and moved throughout the U.S. Midwest. It's oftentimes recognized as the number one most recognizable soybean disease, and certainly as far as total losses, SDS comes in a close second some years to soybean cyst nematode. Now, I should tell you that SDS is made worse or amplified if you have bad SCN infection also. This happens two ways. Basically, you have soybean cyst nematode opening up that root system with the juvenile feeding on the roots, and then it allows the disease to enter the root system more plentifully. But secondarily, it also stresses the plant. Anytime you parasitize a plant, it's going to impact the plant's natural ability to defend itself. So when you have SCN and SDS, that's typically when you see the worst SDS symptoms and the greatest losses. So key things to think about with sudden death syndrome: use a soybean that has very good SDS and SCN resistance. If you can plant on soils that are more drained, or go ahead and tile those very wet soils, that should help. Soil compaction makes SDS worse because it allows a lot more moisture to collect in that root system, providing greater opportunity for that Fusarium root rot to get worse. Rotating with crops that don't encourage soybean cyst nematode helps. Also, using a seed treatment to protect against Fusarium virgiliforme is a very effective means of managing SDS. So this has been Dale Ireland at Valmeyer, Illinois, talking to you about sudden death syndrome, and I want to thank you for your attention.